have been wildfires, you can understand it's incredibly windy up here. I have not been on this peak before, and it was a fun climb up there. I wouldn't mind it being a little less. I'm not going to spend too long up here. You see, there's still snow beneath me. It's a pretty sharp climb up here, but it's beautiful. I'm here on the summit of Elephant Back. It's as beautiful as ever, though that haze is actually smoke from wildfires. It's very dry and very windy. Made it up here in 50 minutes. Hi, I'm on my way to Sepulchre Mountain, which is, I believe, dead ahead. I already came about four and three quarters miles and about 3,000 feet, but as you see, the hard part's still ahead of me. Now, look at that mountain goat on that ledge there. Isn't that amazing? Just standing right on the edge of that cliff. Well, as I get closer to the summit, or on the summit, I'll be back. Those are those mountain goats. I'd only seen one before. There are two of them now. Pretty amazing. So the top of that ridge is where I'm headed, the summit of Sepulchre Mountain. You see, it's quite a view, although some of it's obstructed by the smoke. Fortunately, the smoke really hasn't ruined the air quality that much. You can see now, actually looking down on those goats, this is really spectacular up here. I have not seen a soul. I'm actually on the ridge, the top of Sepulchre Mountain. So those mountain goats are actually right behind me. Sorry, underneath me. That ridge was where I was just before. And that saddle clear down there took a fair amount of work to get up to there. And kind of that valley down there, you can't see it. So because of the smoke, is mammoth. Down there is the town of Gardner, where I'm staying tonight. Just over, we are essentially right on the Wyoming-Montana border right here. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if we were in Montana. Now that beauty there is Electric Peak. I want to climb that tomorrow. The problem is, slight problem, they're supposed to get 4 inches of snow tomorrow, which will make that not possible. It's actually about the same amount of elevation gain as I did just now, although the climb is longer and it's got a bit more technical part to it. So we'll see. If I can't do that, I guess some other day, but you can see Electric Peak almost everywhere in the northern part of the park, so I'd really like to climb it. So you see here, We are right on the ridge here, and you can see in every direction. I'm going to just scramble right over here. Don't worry, I'm not getting too close to the edge here. But you can certainly see this is the summit of a pretty big mountain. Really beautiful. The weather looks terrible. That's the west like it's coming, but I'm not sure. We've been seeing that for a couple of hours. And some of that I think is smoke, so, but I will have my peanut butter sandwich and cherry Coke and be off here pretty quickly. I'm not sure this isn't the actual summit of Sepulchre Mountain, so I'm going to just scramble right to the top here and give it a look. It's actually quite exposed here. You can see it's on its own little peninsula, but like most summit blocks, there's a little space up here. You just don't want to do anything stupid. I realize some people think this is stupid, but I don't. At the summit of Bunsen Peak, I remember Marty reminded me a week ago how foggy it was when we came up here the last time. It's even more so today. Light rain, so very few people, although believe it or not, there are rangers in that cabin because I can hear them. You can see the clouds are really beautiful. They're beneath us in a lot of ways. You can see down to the highway down there. That's where I came up from. I made it up in 58 minutes, which for me is pretty fast. I may go down a way that's longer than I ever have before. There's a couple of smaller summits there, and you go down to this service road down there and go back. It's longer, but it's a different way. So I think I'll take it. This is one of the false summits of Bunsen Peak. I was going to go down there. You can see a waterfall down there. It's called the Osprey Falls. It's supposed to be really beautiful. Well, I got over to that little peak over there and lost the trail. The weather, as you can see, is a bit tempestuous, so I'm not going to fool with it today. So I'm going to return the way I came. It's not the nicest day, but this sure is an interesting view.